It appears that feminists and their indoctrinated public are taking a recent killing of a woman in the UK and turning it into a big party, an opportunity to deem the entire male sex as dangerous. This sentiment may not be new to the feminist mentality of seeing men and masculinity as sources to be mitigated and locked away at best and destroyed at worst, but there is nothing like a good tragedy to excuse themselves to go nuts with it, get in their personal moment to be sexist because, according to them, you can't be sexist against men. This is, of course, nothing more than a means for these neurotic women and their pathetic simps to just feel good about themselves. And no, I'm not exaggerating, since these feminists and their dear white knights use that as the exact reason why they say that all men are dangerous, and why they criticize hashtag not all men. I'll get into my thoughts regarding hashtag not all men momentarily, and my input might not be what most of you would expect, but for now, let's focus on the yes all men idiots. Neurotic feminist women are up in arms about the alleged horrors of being a woman, as only a woman can experience them, and only a man can perpetrate them. Quick to their feet are virtue signaling men, in a never-ending quest to get on these women's good side, as they proclaim how they themselves may not be an evil predator, but they will veer away from walking behind them at night lest she feels unsafe, or that because they are a man, they potentially are a predator, and would proceed to then throw his own sex under the bus in any case. But this disparity of the safety of the sexes, and the sex of those that would compromise it, is in fact a lie. It is absolutely clear by now, at least to anybody that cares about the subject at large and pays attention, that women are just as likely to fill the role of the perpetrator of violence, and men are as likely to be victimized by violence. So it is clear and simple enough, to the chagrin of feminists, that men can perpetrate violence enforced to men can perpetrate violence enforced to women can perpetrate violence enforced to men, and women can perpetrate violence in force to women. There is, however, a real disparity in all this, the visibility of a given permutation of perpetrator and victim. If the feminists and the mass media are any indication, if a woman is victimized by a man, it's a hit sensation, as women have a blast proclaiming how unsafe they are as women, and that men need to either change fundamentally or be given a 6 p.m. curfew, and as spineless men clamor to profess to be on the side of these women for the sake of making them feel less unsafe. If a man is victimized by a man, generally speaking, it is not any form of news, that is, unless there's another angle that they can build upon and make it about, for instance, race. If the George Floyd riots are of any indication, this should be fresh enough in our minds. Or, if in the instance of a Chinese man being killed by a black man, the media will desperately try and spin it into being about white supremacy, of all things. If a woman is victimized by another woman, the story is hushed enough. It is my understanding that lesbian relationships are the ones in which abuses and toxic relationships are the most prevalent, and probably less properly addressed due to the fact that it would clash with the feminist ideology of all women are the sisterhood with zero resentment towards another, because it's only men that must torture these poor women so, right? But finally, it's time to get into when a man is victimized by a woman. When such tragedies happen, either the media is silent and suppressing of the issue, or it is simply laughed into invisibility. The allegedly anti-feminist right views both victim and the men who try to raise the issues as pathetic, and tells them to man up or just take it like a man or something to that effect. Men are dehumanized when they try to talk about their sexual abuse or even rape by a woman, and aside from such remarks as "you lucky dog" or "men can't be raped," the issue becomes dust swept under the carpet. A girl can lie to her family about a babysitter or a teacher having abused her. The innocent man would then, of course, be tortured to death, even beheaded, before the girl fesses up and says that she lied. Of course, the girl gets to remain anonymous and be protected. And if there were any women among the perpetrators of said torture, said murder, her sentence would be vastly lighter than the men's. No public outcry on this sort of story. Is it not fair game to say, hashtag, yes all little girls? Should we disbelieve little girls by default? When one Alexandra Forrestall hit a 54-year-old man with her car, she drove away and left him to die and lied to family, the authorities, and the insurance company about it. When the judge passed sentence to her, she managed to escape with a measly light sentence of 1 year of house arrest, 2 years probation, and a 3-year driving ban. She was able to escape a sentence she deserved more just because she was a woman, and the gynocentrically programmed mentality responded to her poor, remorseful self. Would it not be fair game to say that all women can get off light for killing a man? Hashtag yes all women. A woman abandoned her 6-year-old son in a park, and when the boy tried to cling to her car as she drove away and gets killed because of it, she took and hid the body in the house with assistance from her boyfriend, and then proceeded to lie to the authorities about him being missing. But this is not something that I see so many people up in arms about. It's life as usual. A boy gets killed by a mother, who cares? It's not as sensational as, say, the Casey Anthony case. Could a mother have killed her young daughter? Stop the presses! Would we have known anything about it if it was a son of hers that she killed? Anyway, should we say hashtag yes all mothers? These are only small examples, of course, as feminist organizations celebrate women who murder their husbands and put their efforts into getting women perpetrators out of jail. If a woman can act violently with impunity, what reason is left, hypothetically, for men to trust any given woman? Whereas attention is hyper-focused on women victims of men, and so much as an idea of harassment against a woman by a man is caused to treat women like a royal subject to the species, when it's the other way around, then it's seen as an ideal situation, even funny at worst, and not seen at all at best. That is the true disparity in all of this. When men are brutalized by women, it's status quo. Therein lies the humanity gap between men and women. It's made clear that both sexes can do and perpetrate violence at essentially equal levels. The difference isn't so worth mentioning that it would be a sexed issue. The equation really is as simple as bad and or sick people perpetrate force and violence against other people. It's an eloquent equation, yet unfortunately non-sensational, and nobody can invoke whatever group they happen to fall into as a particularly oppressed class of human being if this equation is used. But once again, the real issue lies in which sex is regarded as human enough to be cared about, as these tragedies happen in practically equal permutations of perpetrator and victim. Now let's talk about hashtag not all men. Despite the fact that I know that those who use that slogan do so with the best of intentions to defend men, as the vast majority of men haven't done anything wrong, even invoking the fact that they are more likely to be women's defenders, the problem lies with the fact that the phrase appears to be in direct affirmation to the hashtag yes all men bullshit, simply offering an exception to what is otherwise status quo. Hashtag not all men works somewhat like this. I agree that yes all men, but not all men. Some of them are okay. The problem of the format not all X is that whatever that it is not all something is something for referring to meager differences and exceptions. Perhaps there is not indeed a strict rule of language and meaning that establishes this, but as far as I can tell under normal circumstances, this sort of phrase refers to these exceptions. For example, not all martinis are made with gin. Some are made with vodka. In the public consciousness, a martini usually refers to a combination of vermouth and gin as a default. The vodka-vermouth mixture is particular enough that it is referred specifically as a vodka martini, an exception, not the rule. If I were to say that not all martinis are made with vodka, while logically correct, there is an implication that vodka is typical for martinis, which, as far as we can tell, is not the case. If you were to simply say, not all men, then even with best intention, you are accidentally conceding the argument, yes all men. It's a weak defense of men that tries to appeal directly to yes all men, as if to say, yes, I agree, yes all men, but not all men. There are some exceptions to that. Some men are actually good. Some men are actually good. What kind of defense of men is that? If you use this slogan and are defensive about your usage of it, consider the argument that I just now postulated, the argument that not all X refers to small exceptions. And you know that men are by and large good. That is the real default. Those that commit evil acts, those who are either immoral or mentally sick enough to commit acts of violent force against others, are the exception. When we speak of being prepared for possible dangers, such as going out in the street at night in some sketchy neighborhood, it is for these exceptions. It is not the status quo. Such is the nature for preparing for these unfortunate possibilities. And both sexes share the same risk of perpetration. And again, it is not status quo. Only if you are a woman brutalized by a man, maybe you'll resurrect some stupid hashtag. I propose an alternative to hashtag not all men, and that is not men. It is not men that commit violence done exclusively to women. Sick men and women, the exceptions and not the norms of humankind, commit violence and not exclusively to women. It is not men. It is sick people. To say yes all men is to make the false blanket accusation that men are a fundamental danger for being men, and exclusively to women, as if men never are ever victims in this fantasy land these feminist neurotics like to call a patriarchy. It is not men that are the designated oppressors, the default perpetrators. Not all men is a whimpering appeal to those that flaunt their belief in the cult of yes all men and tries to get on their good side, trying to make them feel all right, not unlike the male feminist virtue signalers that do their share of nothingness in the name of making women feel less unsafe. Not men, just violent people. Not men, just sick people. Not men, just a relative minority that consists of bad men and women. It is not sexed, therefore not men. Not men means that it is not true that men are helplessly a perpetrator and that only men are. It is not the case. Not men.